Hello friends, welcome to my channel, and today we are going to understand what is film theory for mass transfer. So this theory states that even when two phases are in turbulent motion, still a crucial amount of mass transfer happens between them by diffusion. Okay, even when two phases are in continuous turbulent motion, still a crucial amount of mass transfer happens by diffusion. And now we are going to prove this statement with the help of this theory. Okay, so the given conditions are that there are two phases, either one gas or a liquid, or two liquid phases which are immiscible, or some other combination. So there are two phases, and both of these phases are in turbulent flow. Now these are the two phases, one in organic phase, one is aqueous phase, both of them are immiscible. And there, at the point of contact of these two phases, there is a boundary which is known as phase boundary. Okay, this boundary is known as phase boundary. And according to this theory, the turbulence dies at the phase boundary, which means there is no turbulence at the phase boundary. Okay, turbulence at the phase boundary is zero. Okay, and now we assume that there are a few thin films. There are thin films on each side of the phase boundary, which are also relatively stagnant. So this bulk is entirely in turbulent flow. Okay, and this phase boundary is having zero turbulence. But this region, which is on the sides of the phase boundary, is the region which is known as boundary layer or fluid film, and it is also relatively stagnant compared to the bulk. So see, I have written the same thing here, that the phase boundary or interface is the meeting point of two phases. This is the meeting point of two phases, and the turbulence dies at the phase boundary. Okay, the turbulence dies at the phase boundary, and boundary layer or fluid film is formed adjacent to the phase boundary. So this is the phase boundary, and these are the fluid films. Okay, this is the aqueous fluid film, and this is the organic fluid film. Okay, now adjacent to the phase boundary, there is a formation of fluid film, and these fluid films are relatively stagnant. Now let us understand that how does the concentration vary throughout the system of a component A which we want to transfer. Okay, so we want to transfer the component A from this region to this region, and let us see how the concentration of component A varies in the system. So we see that concentration of component A in the aqueous phase, bulk of the aqueous phase, which is being continuously mixed. Okay, the bulk is in turbulent motion, so it is well mixed. So the concentration of component A in the bulk is constant, but as it reaches the relatively stagnant region, it decreases, and then we get to the phase boundary. And at the phase boundary, the concentration of component A is Ca1i. Okay, the concentration of component A at the phase boundary is Ca1i. In the same way, the concentration of component A in the bulk on this side, which is being continuously mixed, is constant, which is Ca2. And at the interface, it is Ca2i. It changes because this region is relatively stagnant. At the interface, it is Ca2i. And we see that the phase boundary is itself in equilibrium. Okay, the phase boundary is in equilibrium, which means if you want to transport material just across the phase boundary, just across this line, it won't give any resistance. There won't be any resistance to transfer material just across this line, because this phase boundary is under equilibrium. And now let us see how does the mass transfer happens from this point to this point. Okay, so let me draw it here. So x1 is the point here, then we get here, this is y1. This is the point at which the boundary layer crosses, phase boundary crosses. So this is the line, this is y2, the boundary layer on the organic side, and this is the bulk of the organic side. And now we are going to see how this A component gets transported throughout this region. Okay, how this A component moves from x1 to x2. And if you see, from x1 to y1, this mixture is in turbulent flow or is well mixed. So there is no need of diffusion here. Okay, so the material can directly, with the help of turbulence flow, can move from here to here. So this will be moved by the turbulent flow. But from y1 to z, it is relatively stagnant. From y1 to z, this region is relatively stagnant, and therefore turbulent flow is not going to help us in the movement of the component A. And hence, In this region, we use what? Diffusion. In this region, diffusion happens. And we know that diffusion happens from higher concentration to lower concentration. So here if we see, the concentration of component A is high, and here the concentration of component A is low. So the diffusion happens from this point to this point. And now from Z to Y2, again this region is relatively stagnant. And again we see that at Ca2i, at the interface, here the concentration of component A is high, and here the concentration of component A is low. Therefore, diffusion again happens from this Z point to Y2 point. From this Z point to Y2 point, again diffusion happens. But from Y2 to X2, the turbulent flow again comes into picture. So this is a bit complex, but you need to understand that from Y2 to X2, the turbulent flow again comes into picture. And because there is well mixing, there is well turbulent flow, from Y2 to X2, it will be done by the turbulent flow. The motion of component A from Y2 to X2 will be done by the turbulent flow. So if you see, wherever there is turbulent flow, there is no resistance to mass transfer. But in this region, which is relatively stagnant, this region requires diffusion for mass transfer. So we say that these boundary layers are the only region in this system which provide resistance to mass transfer. Now, there is one question, okay, one important question, and that is that Ca1i and Ca2i are two different concentration. So how can the system be in equilibrium with two different concentration? Okay, so let us understand this. So I am saying that this is the phase boundary, okay, so this is the organic phase, this is the aqueous phase, and the concentration here is Ca1i, the concentration here is Ca2i. Both of the concentrations are different, but still, how can the phase boundary be in equilibrium? And the reason is because of the solubility. Okay, there are chances that, suppose we are talking about acetic acid, so the solubility of acetic acid in the aqueous region is different, and in the organic phase it is different. Okay, in the aqueous phase, the solubility of a particular compound, suppose any compound, the solubility of a X compound, suppose it is higher in the aqueous phase. So the concentration of Ca1i is going to be high, and the concentration Ca2i is going to be low, because the solubility is low. So it is because the solubility itself is low, that X component is very much soluble in the aqueous solution, but that X component is not very much soluble in the organic phase. Therefore, the system is in equilibrium even though there is a concentration difference. Okay, so this theory in summary states that even though the fluid is under turbulent motion, a crucial amount of mass transfer, a huge crucial amount of mass transfer happens by diffusion, because there is a formation of phase boundary, and adjacent to phase boundary there is a relatively stagnant region, and in that stagnant region turbulence does not play any role, and hence only way of mass transfer is diffusion. In the next video, we are going to talk about convective mass transfer. Thank you.